Wherever there are people, there are usually critters living nearby, taking advantage of the free buffet. And we've traditionally gone to extremes to keep these pests away. But what if, instead of lethal traps or chemical spray, there was another way? One that relied on sound to keep the bugs at bay. Well, that's all science, no fiction.
Okay, so we've got two units here. We'll place these two units out.
Von Walton is an entomologist with a new toy.
Okay. You want to see it?
Yeah.
So let's connect it. This is the test run here.
It's a device designed to communicate with insects through vibrations.
You can feel it with your hand. That's the signal.
If the conversation goes well, the device, nicknamed the Pied Piper, could eventually save one of the Pacific Northwest's most important crops from a sneaky little bug called a tree hopper and the potentially devastating disease it spreads in vineyards.
With Pied Piper, we're trying to find an alternative that is clean, that is environmentally safe, to try and get rid of these bugs without using any toxic pesticides.
The Pied Piper works by taking advantage of how some insects communicate through vibrations.
It's all about saving energy. The females must use as little energy as they can so that they can produce as many eggs and many offspring as they can.
Saving energy means being as efficient as possible in finding a mate. The tree hoppers do this by playing an elaborate game of telephone. They vibrate their abdomens, and the sound travels through whatever they happen to be standing on.
The mates will find that signal, they will zone in on them, and they will be able to mate.
The Pied Piper robot does something very similar. It plays the tree hopper's call to lure the insects in. Walton is testing the device over the summer at Mark Huff's vineyard in Northwest Oregon.
This one right here.
Why this one?
It's doing well. Therefore, it might attract the insects.
For Huff, dealing with pest problems is constant work.
From the moment that the grapes unfurl from their buds, you are thinking about it all the time. And if you're in the organic business, like we are here, you have a very limited amount of tools in the tool chest.
Walton attaches the device's microphone and speaker to the grapevine.
Got the high-tech rubber band here.
There you go.
Pied Piper will listen for tree hoppers, and when it hears one,
the computer will send a mating signal through this wire back onto the stem.
When the tree hopper feels the signal, it'll come running. Luring tree hoppers out into the open is a bigger deal than it may seem. They're experts at staying hidden and annoying the scientists looking for them.
As you get closer to them, they'll be sitting on one side of the stem and they'll just move around to the back of it and you just won't see them.
The tree hoppers themselves only do minor damage to grapevines, but they're carriers of a much more sinister plant virus called red blotch.
With red blotch, we're seeing reduction in photosynthesis in the plant itself. What that translates towards winemaking is that you have less of these volatiles that we as humans love in wines. The perception is that the quality of those wines are not as good.
The Pied Piper has already shown it can lure tree hoppers in, but does it then kill them? No. The hope is to use the device's communication with the tree hoppers to keep them from making babies. It's a technique called mating disruption.
Mating disruption is kind of like birth control.
The idea is to confuse and distract, keep the bugs from finding each other.
You have an adult female that most likely is able to mate and should lay eggs within 3 or 4 days. If you can delay that, you can cut the capacity of this insect being able to reproduce, sometimes in half, sometimes 90%.
it could be a revolutionary solution for organic vineyards. Yet treehoppers aren't the only buggy pests farmers are dealing with. And they're also not the only insects that communicate through vibration.
That worked okay. There is a bunch of low-frequency stuff still.
It's been Oregon State undergrad Vincent Von Uding's job to train the Pied Piper to recognize treehopper calls. Now he's expanding its repertoire.
We're working on getting the devices to work for brown marmorated stink bugs, which are another pretty major agricultural pest.
The stink bugs are recent invaders in the Pacific Northwest, and they're starting to cause damage to hazelnut crops.
In general, bugs are annoying. They're very finicky.
But to speak to stink bugs, Pied Piper has to know the language. And that starts with recording their communication with a vibration sensing laser.
Vibrometer. It can measure it with very high accuracy, just vibrations in a thing you pointed at. I'm going to try to get a stem. We can get recordings that the traps can play back later in order to lure the insects towards them. And it's also how we can figure out how we need to tune our detection algorithm, like what dominant frequencies and harmonics we need to look at.
Once the insects are on the test plant, the recording and waiting begins.
They usually take a little while to like get acclimated before they start doing stuff.
Yet almost immediately, the male and female stink bugs strike up a conversation.
Yeah. I think we already got a chirp. If you look in here, you see these little streaks. The main thing that we were looking for is just some signal that had very sharp, well-defined frequencies in it. It's kind of like the difference between white noise and a human voice.
The frequencies of the stink bug's call fall within human hearing range. And all it takes is a little processing and encouragement from Walton.
You got a signal?
Are you serious?
For the glorious mating call of the brown marmorated stink bug to ring out.
Play it. Can you play
yeah,
it?
Yeah, there's a lot of noise.
That's okay, don't apologize. Yeah. Just play it. I can hear it.
Yeah.
You can hear
so,
it.
So yeah, it's in there.
If the Pied Piper can stop treehoppers and other insects, it will achieve something pesticides are incapable of.
I think the key thing here is that it only affects the target insect. It's cleaner for everyone that lives here. It's better for our salmon and our rivers. You can't see these bugs, you can't hear them, but now we have a method of detecting them, which we never were able to do in the past.
And the more songs the Pied Piper learns to play, the more pests it can mesmerize and lead astray.
It's such a beautiful day in the Willamette Valley.
All science, no fiction wouldn't be possible without the support and good vibrations we get from OPB members. Thanks. And don't miss out on any of OPB's science, history, outdoors, and arts programs by subscribing to OPB Insider at opb.org/allscience.
All right, we got it.